In learning giants, both front and back giants can be developed simultaneously. You don't have to wait to learn one before the other. You can work on both at the same time. It's typical that most people learn the back giants first these days, but not necessary that it has to be done that way. But anyway, in developing the back giants, as I said before, we're going to try to do this without even using a spotter. We're going to go through all the basic drills. And we're going to start from square one and go on from there. So the first thing I'm going to start with is having the gymnast just learning how to feel what's called a tap. And he or she is eventually going to use a tap swing in order to perform these giants. However, just learning how to pike and arch and pike and arch, as demonstrated, is most important for the gymnast to do first. After they learn that, the next step is to learn the actual tap swing. And what I always remind gymnasts is on the front and back swing, they need to see their toes. Hollow in the back, toes up in the front. That's going to help them to get their body in the correct position. After they've learned a good tap swing, and it takes a very long time to master it, then they can go on to the next step. And the next step is tapping into a long hang pullover. I'm going to stop for a second and remind everybody, before a gymnast ever does a long hang pullover or tries to do it out of a tap swing, I recommend that they have some fundamental practice in doing a free hip or a clear hip. If they can't do a free hip or clear hip at all, they're going to have a hard time flipping their wrist on this type of an element. So learning a free hip or a clear hip is going to be very helpful in making sure that they're able to flip their wrist and get back up on top of the bar.